संहिताम् ह्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. द डिफरेण्ट् सब् डिविशन्स् आफ् रूपकं वि हेव् सीन् फोर् आफ् दि एक्साम्पल्स्. समस्तवस्तुविषयम् एकदेशविवर्ति, देन् शुद्धं निरङ्गं रूपकं, मालारूपं निरङ्गं रूपकं. वि लुकिङ्ग् एट् श्लिष्टं केवलं परम्परितं रूपकम्. From there we have to start. So alaukika mahaloka prakashita jagatrayaha stuyate deva sadvamsha mukta ratnam na kaihi bhavan. Bhavan, a kavi is addressing a king here, and he says, hey deva, rajan, bhavan kaihi na stuyate. You are, by whom are you not praised, or who does not praise you in this world? You are like alaukika mahaloka prakashita jagatrayaha. Prakashita jagatrayaha, you are brightening all three worlds because you have with your alaukika mahaloka. Maha alokaha is suryaha. So prakashaha, it is something beyond this lokam. Alaukika prakasha yuktaha tvam jagatrayamapi prakashayasi. So you are brightening all three worlds with your very unique prakasham that you have. Another thing is sadvamsha mukta ratnam. You are like a pearl, mukta ratnam, in a sadvamsha, in a very good, in a noble race, of a noble race. So that sadvamsha has two meanings here. Vamsha also means bamboo tree. Vamsha also means kulam. So here both meanings are being used here as a slesha, which is the sadharana dharmam. You are like a pearl in a good kulam or a noble race, with that noble race is like bamboo. So the so just like mukta ratnam is found in the temples of uttamagaja or in cobras. And now this is also another place where pearls are found inside the hollow space of a bamboo. When you break a bamboo, which is of a good quality, that is supposed to have pearls inside its nodes. So you are like a pearl inside a sadvamsha, in a noble race, just like how pearls are found in bamboo tree. Here, how does that work? Slishtam is slesha, where you have two meanings, which is for sadvamshaha, both satkulam and sadvenuhu. That is where the rupakam also exists. And sadvamshaha eva sadvenuhu. The another rupakam that you are using here is the raja is being superimposed with the mukta ratnam, with the pearl. So atra raja eva varnaniyaha vastu. आरोप्यमाणं वस्तु तु मुक्तावरत्नम् अत्र. तत्र निमित्तं किं? सद्वंशः इत्येव निमित्तम्. बीङ्ग् बोर्न् इन् अ गुड् कुलम्, द पर्ल् आल्सो इस् फौण्ड् इन् अ गुड् वेणु. सद्वंशे विद्यमानं मुक्तारत्नम् इव राजा सद्वंशे विद्यमानः मुक्तारत्नः रत्नम्. यु केन् हाव् बोत् पुल्लिङ्गम् अण्ड् नपुंसकलिङ्गम् इन् द सेम् विभक्ति as an adjective. So here that nimittam is your reason for classifying it under paramparitam. So paramparitam is where one rupakam is the karanam for another rupakam. For me to identify raja with mukta ratnam, I need the nimittam of sadvamsha and sadkula. Sadvamsha is sadvenu, venu is bamboo. So sadvamsha eva sadkulam iti rupakam. तत्र राज्ञः एव राजा एव मुक्तारत्नम् इति रूपकस्य निमित्तभूतं भवति. ओके, इन् द सेम् वे द नेक्स्ट् वन् इस् माला, नाट् मालारूपं, केवलं परम्परितम्. ऐ थिङ्क् दिस् वन् इस् श्लिष्ट. दिस् इस् मालारूपं वा? सारि, ऐ मेड् अ मिस्टेक्. अमालारूपम् अपि परम्परितं द्रष्टव्यम्. वै डस् ही गिव् टु एक्साम्पल्स्? ऐ कम्प्लीट्लि फर्गॉट्. ओके निरवधि च निराश्रयं च यस्य स्थितिम् अनिवर्तित कौतुक प्रपञ्चम् प्रथमः इह भवान् सकूर्ममूर्तिः जयति चतुर्दश लोकवल्लि कन्दः. This is केवलं this is अश्लिष्टम् sorry because I didn't put the different there is no slesha here and I just wrote it as slishtaha sorry there is no slesha I'll just make that corrections here I made the correction now so it's better niravadhi cha nirashrayam cha yasya sthitam anivartita kautuka prapancham prathamaha iha bhavan sakurma murtihi jayati chaturdasha lokavalli kandaha poet is describing kurmamurtihi sakurmamurtihi bhavan eva kurmamurtihi and that he is comparing a raja to Vishnu or a kavi can just describe Vishnu himself here so the context most of the times is unknown for us why and what even here in the vyakhyanam he has not given us the context here at all if you see he has just directly started the meaning of the text and he is not given us so Vishnu eva kandatva arope sati that is the only idea so it could also be either a kavi describing a king or any poet who is just describing Vishnu himself so that could also be the context here yasya sthitam nirvartita kautuka prapancha bhavan niravadhi you are always victorious kusa kurma murtihi jayati this kurma form this kurma avatara always is prathamaha kurma murtihi that primordial or primeval kurma murti the first avataram that that kurma avataram came into this world was Vishnu who took that avataram so saha kurma murtihi that form of that turtle jayati saha kurma avataraha jayati how is that chaturdasha loka valli kandaha it is a kanda it is like a root for chaturdasha bhuvanam it is the root for all the 14 worlds so the 14 worlds are like a creeper chaturdasha lokani lokah eva vallihi or vallayah for a creeper you need a root and kurma avatara is the root for holding up the 14 worlds so that is your rupakam here the rest of it is yasya sthitam whose existence is anivartita kautuka is niravadhi niravadhi there is limitless existence he is nityam there is no adihi anadihi anantaha nityabhutaha niravadihi nirashrayam it does not need any other support kurmavatara is the support for everything else in this world and that kurmavatara does not need another support for its existence so yasya sthitam niravadhi his existence is endless or infinite and nirashrayam which does not need any other support anivartita kautuka prapancham kautuk prapancham it is always unique it induces our curiosity it increases our curiosity all the time so anivartita anivartita kautukam means I am done whatever the kurma avatara can achieve has been achieved I have seen what has to be seen and this is all there is my kautukam has stopped my curiosity I don't have any curiosity to understand about we can never say that so anivartita kautukam means my curiosity is never finished as far as the kurma avatara is concerned I want to know more and more about it so anivartita kautuka prapancham it is never without any curiosity or uniqueness kautukam can also mean uniqueness because of that uniqueness is what gives us that curiosity to understand more and more about how that kurma avatara can exist like this so anivartita kautuka prapancham yasya sthitam the existence of kurma avatara is such that it is niravadhi there is no limit nirashrayam no other support it does not need a support for its existence and its existence is always associated with uniqueness and curiosity tadrishah prathamah saha kurma murtihi bhavan chaturdasha lokavalli kandaha jayati you exist as a root for all the 14 worlds. Here Kurma Murtihi is the Varnaniya Vastu, and what is being superimposed here? Aropyamanam Kim Kandaha. Kanda is root. So if you are superimposing the idea of root on the idea of Kurma Avatara, and that root needs a support. Why does he say that Kurma Avatara is like a root, Moolam? Why does he say that? Because he is using the Rupakam for Chaturdasha Loka as a valli. He is superimposing creeper onto the 14 worlds. And for that existence of that valli, for the existence of a creeper, you need its root. And here the 14 worlds can exist only with the support of Kurma Avatara. Huh? The root does not need another root for its existence, right? So that's how you'll have to take all of those adjectives to that Rupakam also, and you can understand that in a better manner. So Chaturdasha Loka Valli Kandaha is your Sadharana Dharmaha for both Kurma Murtihi and Kandaha. It is the Sadharana Dharmam. Chaturdasha Loka Valli, that is also in Rupakam. Hence it is Paramparita Rupakam because it is a Karana. There is no Slesha associated there. So it is Aslishtaha Sadharana Dharmaha. So Aslishtam Kevalam Paramparitam. There is no Mala Rupam here where one Upamanam, so one Upameyam is there, and there are many different Upamanam with the, like in a garland. That is Mala Rupam. This is Kevalam. Okay. I think we saw the Mala Rupam before. Next is like in Upama Alankara, he is also taking up Rashana Rupakam and saying that there is no Chamatkaram in this. And hence I have not defined that or taken it up as a different Alankara. Kisalaya Karaihi Latanam Karakamalaihi Kaminam Mano Jayati Nalininam Kamalamukaihi Mukhendubihi Yoshitam Madanaha. Madanaha Jayati Kaminam Manaha Jayati. Manmatha defeats the mind of Kami, of the hearts of the Kami, the lovers. He captures the hearts, or he akarshanam karoti, manaha, kaminam manaha akarshanam karoti. Madanaha katham kisalaya karaihi, latanam kisalaya karaihi. So there are the idea first is Manmatha captures the minds of the lovers in such a, with creepers. So during Vasanta Ritu, there are many creepers with small, small kisalayam sprouts, and that sprout attracts the minds of the lovers. So it is, it increases, it's an uddipana vibhavam. And yoshitam kara, kara kamalam. So the creepers also attract them. The ladies' beautiful hands attract them. Nalininam kamalani. Lotuses in the lotus ponds also attract. Yoshitam mukhani api. The faces of the ladies also attract. Now all of these are being used in a Rupakam here. How? He says with hand-like leaves of the creepers, Madana attracts the mind of Kamis. Kamina manaha madanaha harati katham latanam kisalayaihi kararupa kisalayaihi. Kisalayaha eva karaha. So here that aropam happens on, there is a superimposition of karatvam on kisalayam. Now the kara becomes the varnaniyam in the next one. So here the first one, kisalaya is the varnaniyam. Karam, karaha is your aropana vastu, aropyamana vastu. The next one is yoshitam karakamalaihi madanaha kaminam manaha jayati. He attracts the minds of lovers with the lotus-like hands of women. So, atra yoshitam karaha varnaniyaha kamalani aropyavastuni kamalattu aropaha vartate. So, the first, in the first rupakam, the one that was the aropyamana vastu becomes the varnaniya vastu in the second one, second rupakam. And that which is the aropyamana vastu, kamalam, becomes the Varnaniya vastu in the third one. Nalininam kamala mukaihi madanaha kaminam manaha jayati. he also attracts with lotus-like faces of the lotus ponds. So the lotuses in the lotus ponds are looking like faces. They are as beautiful as the faces of the ladies. Here, Kamale Mukhatva Aropaha. The next Rupakam is Yoshitam Mukha Indubihi. Yoshitam Mukhe Indutva Aropaha. Nalininam Kamala Mukhehi Ityatra Rupake Aropyamana Vastutvena Mukham Asti. Dvitiye, the fourth one, you will have Mukha, which is the Aropyamana Vasta in the previous one, has become the Varnaniya Vastu in the last one. So Mukhe Indutva Aropaha. He also attracts people with the moon-like faces of women. This is a Rashana Rupakam. There is no Vaichitriyam here. Rashana Rupakam na Vaichitriyavatu iti na Lakshitam. It's more complicated than understanding. It's difficult to understand the beauty of this shlokam. Right? With this, we conclude Rupakam and move on to Apannuti. Apannuti is where when an object is being described, it is negated and another Aropyamana Vastu is confirmed there. In Rupakam, we have only seen two things are being, you know, used parallelly. There is no negation of the Varnaniya Vastu. Here the Varnaniya Vastu is being negated and the Aropyamana Vastu, Upamanam, is being established as the truth. So prakritam yat nishidhya anyat sadhyate satu apannutihi. Prakritam nishidhya upameya vastum nishidhya. Nishidhya meaning asatyam krutva. Upameyam asatyam krutva anyat sadhyate anyat upamanam. Upamanam katham sadhyate satyataya sthapyate. So upameyam asatyam krutva upamanam asatyataya yat sthapyate sa apannutihi. So there are two types of apannuti according to Kavya Prakashakara. In Kolyanandam, you will find 5-6 different varieties of apannuti. Here, Kavya Prakasha Mammata simplifies the work for us and just gives two types, Shabdi and Arthi. In Arthi, there can be different types. That is left to the Sahridaya or the Kavi Pratibha. Here, Shabdi is where directly he says, na. Iti shabdam upayujya yatra nishedaha kriyate tatra shabdi apannutihi. So the first example is of shabdi apannutihi. Avaptav pragalbhyam paranata ruchas shailatanaye kalanko naivayam vilasati shashankasya vapushi amushya iyam manye vigalatu amrita syanda shishire rati shiranta shete rajani ramani gadham urasi. Shiva is addressing Parvati and saying, Parvati, you know that the moon, there is no kalankam in that moon. That whatever you perceive as kalankam in the moon, it is not. Naiva ayam shashankasya vapushi ayam kalankaha naiva. It is not a kalanka that is there in the shariram of Shashanka, of the moon, which is avaptav pragalbhyam. Pragalbhyam avaptaha, it has attained a great, it is shining with full luster. The parinata ruchaha shashankasya vapushi. Parinata ruchaha is purnachandran. So in if it is a small kala, we won't be able to see that kalankam clearly. You will only see the prakasha yuktam chandran. Only in the purnachandra you can see that kalankam with its full force also. Right, so parinata ruchaha shashankasya. Parinata ruchaha shashti vibhakti as an adjective for shashanka. Shashanka, the moon, which is full in its luster. Parinata ruchaha tasya kantihi parinatam asti purnam sampurnataya prakashate chandraha tadrisha chandrasya vapushi sharire pragalbhyam avaptaha ayam kalankaha. This beautiful pragalbhyam means saundaryam avaptaha, saundaryam praptaha ayam kalankaha. He doesn't look at it as a chinnam or malinam, malinatvam. He doesn't say lanchanam or anything. He only looks at it as pragalbhyam avaptaha, saundaryam avaptaha, athava vriddhim avaptaha. that which is you know very prominent. You can see that kalankam in a very prominent way in the moon. So pragalbhyam avaptaha ayam kalankaha naiva vilasati. It is not a kalankam that you see which is there. There is a patch on that moon that you see, right? Kintu iyam, it is actually, you know, the knight who has been ratishranta iyam rajani ramani. Rajani Nidra is also in Strilingam. So he fancies her as the moon's lover. So I think it is the lover, the knight, Rajani Ramani, Amushya, Ratishranta, Amushya Vigalat Amrita Syandi Shishire Urasi Gadham Shete. I think she's so tired from the night, the Ratikeli from the night before, and she is just lying down on his lap, on his urasi, on his chest. So it is like a lady who is very sharanta. She is very tired after ratikeli. Vigalate amrita syandi shishire urasi, on his chest, which is very, you know, amrita syandi, which is shishiram, cold with the amritam that is coming. So Chandra is supposed to be very cool. The moonlight is supposed to be cool, whereas the sunlight is supposed to be very ushnam. Yeah? So vigalatu amrita syandi shishire urasi. Chandra's, the moon's uras chest is very cold, and she is Rati Shranta. She's very tired, so she needs a cool place to just lie down. Abdi saanji karathukku venum, you know, andha maadhiri abdi oru romba kalachu poi irukirche. You don't feel like lying down actually, but you just want to adu eppadi solradhu saanji karathungiradhu enna solradhu, I don't know how to say that. You don't want to lie down, but you just want to be against something, la adapdi andha maadhiri, you want to just lie against his chest. So that is the idea that he is giving. It's about a kamini and a kamukaha. Amushya chandrasya urasi ratishranta rajani gadham shete. Gadham shete means she's so, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's a Telugu word for what you said, Akka, but I don't know the English exactly.
I know.
But I got your point.
Okay, good. Yeah, just as long as you understand that.
Okay.
I'm trying to think what word would be best. I can't even figure out. That's okay. As long as you get that idea. So, Amushya Chandrasya Shishire Urasi Gadham Shete. She just lies against his chest because she is Rati Shranta. She's very tired. I know this is so much better than the example that Kolyananda Kara gives, no? Ankan Kepe Shashankare.
Pretty funny, Tare.
I know.
Pretty funny, Tare.
This is so beautiful. And the idea of it, applo alaga irukku. Till now, I was thinking Ankan K.P. Shashankare is so beautiful. I think it's more because of...
Amma, yaar sonnadu, Vaktra Vaishishtyam.
Amma. Nagaraj Mahadeva oda vaarthai enala da, it's so beautiful, the way he describes it. I want to see how he describes this. Avapta pragalbhyam parinadarachaha shailatanaye. Adha, the way, if you imagine Shiva telling it to Parvati, and the play behind that the suggestion and everything is so beautiful in the shloka. Idha poi or alankarathukku example a kuduthukara.
Ama adhi anga kuduthirukalam engiyadhu panjadu ulasiyo ara na muna nalaadu ulasiyo.
Ama rasathukku kuduthirukalam, alaga irukku.
Ama nalla irukku. Yaarodathu idhu
theriyala. I don't know if it is given.
இது மாத்திரம் அபிநவ குப்தர் கையில
அகப்படுத்திருந்ததுன்னா வை ரஜினி ரமணிங்கிறது வந்து ஏன் அதை வந்து நைட்டா வந்து கம்பேர் பண்ணணும்னா, யூ கேன் ஆல்சோ டேக் இட் அஸ் ஸ்லேஷாலங்கார துவனி வேர் நோ டோன்ட் டோன்ட் காட் மீ ஆன் ஆல் திஸ் ஐம் ஜஸ்ட் ட்ரைங் டு திங்க் இட் குட் பீங் ஷியாமாங்கிற அர்த்தத்துக்கு யூனோ. சோ ரஜினி அப்படி ஷியாமா, சோ ஷியாமா இத்தியுக்தே யுவதி இல்லையா, ஷீஸ் அ யங் கேர்ள் லைக் வது ஹூ இஸ் ரதிஷ் ராந்தா. சோ ஷி இஸ் ஆல்சோ அந்த ஷியாமத்வம்ங்கிறதுனால அங்க வந்து கம்பாரிசன் போடுறாரு. கலங்கா அபி ஷியாமா, ரஜினி அபி ஷியாமா, காமுகிங்கிறச்சே அந்த காந்தா, வதுஹூங்கிறச்சே ஷியாமா அப்படிங்கிறது அவளுக்கும். பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஸ்லோகன்.
சோ இந்த இடத்துல அந்த மன்னியே வர்றதுனால திஸ் இஸ் இது வந்து
மன்யே வந்து உத்பிரேக்ஷா எடுத்துக்க வேண்டாம். ஹியர் இட் இஸ் மோர் லைக் நைவ கலங்கா இது சப்த உபாத்தா. அண்ட் மன்யேங்கிறது வந்து இட் இஸ் நாட் உத்பிரேக்ஷா ஆர் ஃபேன்சி, பட் இட் இஸ் அ சத்தியத்வேன ஸ்தாபிதம்னு எடுத்துக்கணும் அந்த இடத்துல. இட் இஸ் ரதிஷ்ராந்தா ரஜனியேவ தத்ர வர்த்ததே இது அப்படிங்கறதோட நிறுத்திக்கணும். மன்யேன்னு பிராயஹாங்கிற அர்த்தத்துல எடுத்துக்கூடாது. டோன்ட் டேக் இட் அஸ் பிராயா, இது அதுதான் சத்தியத்வேன ஸ்தாபியதே அப்படி புரிஞ்சுக்கணும். பட் மோர் தென் சாப்தி அபன்னுதி எங்க அப்ளை ஆகுதுன்னா நைவ கலங்கா இத்தியத்திர சப்த உபாத்தா நிஷேதா, அதனால சாப்தி. வெரிஸ் இன் ஆர்த்தி யூ வில் ஃபைண்ட் த வேர்ட்ஸ் சல கைதவ ஆல் ஆஃப் தோஸ் ஆர் புட் இன் அண்டர் ஆர்த்தி அபன்னுதி.
So, just like Ankanke Pile, Kukshistam Achakshmahe and Achakshmahe Maan in a Manye Vartum.
Yes.
Okay.
So, Ankanke Pishashankire, Jalanithe, Pankam Pare Meenire, Angavandhu, even every one of those is actually a Nishidhya Anyasya Uktihi. So, Ankam Kepi Shashankire, Shashankire, Shashanka, Shanka is there. That also then you will be thinking that it is Utreksha. No, it is not. அங்கம் நிஷித்ய கே அபி பரே ஜலநிதே பங்கம் இதி சங்கிரே, தட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ சத்தியத்வேன ஸ்தாபனம் ஒன்லி சுத்தா அபன்னுதி. So the definition in Kuvalyanandam he gives, the explanation he gives there is varnaniye vastuni tat sadrisha dharma aropa phalakaha tadiya dharma ninnavaha. So, kavi mati vikasa utprekshita dharmantarasya api va ninnavaha. So, either utprekshita dharmasya ninnavaha, athava sadrisha dharma aropa palakena tadiya dharma ninnavaha. Either svatasambhavaha ankam nishidhya utprekshitaha dharmaha, utprekshita dharmasya api nishidhya vera oru dharmata podra. சாரங்கம் கதிச்ச சஞ்சகதிரே புச்சாய மைச்சன் பரி இந்தோயத்தலிதேந்திரன்.
அவர் சொல்றது அழகா இருக்கு.
அவரோட அது தட் இஸ் தி பியூட்டி ஆஃப் எ பர்சன் ஹூ யூனோ அவ ரசிச்சு தேர் டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டிங் தேர் இது இல்ல தேர் ரசனா டு அஸ் தென் இட் பிகம்ஸ் மோர் பியூட்டிஃபுல் instead of just merely reading the shlokam to ourselves. Sometimes I wish, you know, I will hear all this from someone else for me to appreciate the way they appreciate it. Anyway.
நாங்களாம் கொடுத்து வச்சிருக்கோம், உங்ககிட்ட இருந்து கேட்க முடியாது.
இதெல்லாம் I wish I can listen from, you know, Nagaraj Mahode. அவரோடது வந்து டிஃப்ரெண்டா இருக்கும். அப்படியே கொடுத்து வைக்கணும். வைரம் ஸ்மரஸ்ய பிரிய விரஹ கிருஷே அஸ்மின் ராகிலோகே ததாஹி உபவன சஹகார உத்பாசி பிருங்கச்சலேன பிரதிவிஷிகம் அனேன உட்டங்கிதம் காலகூட்டம். Talking about her viraham to another person, another friend, hey Sakhi, Bata Sakhi. Bata is also Harshe, Shoke, anything. Athava, aho, hey Sakhi, ityatra, Bata Sakhi. Something like a yo friend, Abhring Ramadri. Agana oru vartha adu. And the Bata is so expressive and it changes according to the context. It can be used in any manner. Yeah, Bata Sakhi. प्रिय विरह कृषे अस्मिन् रागिलोके स्मरस्य कियत् वैरम् एतत् पश्य. सी दिस् मन्मथ हेज् सो मच् आफ् एनिमिटी टुवर्ड्स् लवर्स् हु आर् सेपरेटेड् एण्ड् हु आर् आल्रेडी थिन्. प्रिय विरहेण कृषे रागिलोके, रागिलोके दोस् हु आर् आल् पेशनेट् टुवर्ड्स् लवर्स्, दोस् हु आर् लवर्स् एण्ड् तादृश कामुक लोके ये आल् आफ् दोस् पीपल् इन् दट् यु नो इन् दट् समूहम् आर् प्रिय विरहेण कृशाः रागिणः तेषु स्मरस्य कियद् वैरम् इति पश्य. लुक् एट् द विरोधिता दट् ही हेज् टुवर्ड्स् आल् आफ् दीस्. नो वै डस् ही से तथा हि बिकास् इन् ईच् आफ् दोस् सहकार फ्लवर्. सो मन्मथास् एरोस् आर् फ्लवर्स्, पुष्पबाणः सः. And when he just uses those flowers itself, it increases the viraham in all the lovers and they become even more thin. Now they are already thin because of the viraham. Now he wants to, he has so much of virodham that he has taken each and every flower, sahakara udbhasi upavane, sahakara udbhasi, in the garden there are so many mango trees in the garden, and each of those mango trees have black bees on them, those mango flowers have black bees on them. It is as if he has just applied poison to each and every flower and he is throwing it on us. That bringam is like a kalakutam. So sahakara upavaneshu सहकार वृक्षाः सन्ति, तेषां पुष्पेषु उद्भासि भृङ्गच्छलेन. अण्डर् द प्रिटेक्स्ट् आफ् ब्लाक् बीस् विच् आर् फ्लैङ्ग् ओवर् दोस् फ्लवर्स्, दोस् मेङ्गो फ्लवर्स् इन् द गार्डन्, हि हेस् आक्चुलि अप्लैड् प्रतिविशिखम् उट्टङ्कितम्. उट्टङ्कितं मीन्स् हि हेस् जस्ट् अप्लैड्. इवन् द वर्ड् उट्टङ्कितं, the harsh letter that he uses there to show the virodhita that Manmatha has. So very beautiful shlokam this is. So uttankitam, he has applied poison, kalakutam uttankitam, prati vishikam, in every flower, in every vishikam means arrow, to every, each and every one of his arrow, which is that flower, sahakara pushpam, bringachalena, under the pretext of a black bee, he has actually applied poison. So when someone wants to kill another person, they apply poison to the sharp head of the arrows, and poisoned arrows are much more dangerous, right? Even a slight scratch, the poison will enter through the blood. You don't need to kill directly. So even a slight, if we just look at that pushpam itself, it causes more damage to the persons who are in, to the lovers in separation. So kiyad vairam pasya manmathasya. Okay, atrahi na sa bringani sahakarani apitu sa kalakutaha asharaha iti pratitihi. Now here the upameya vastu is bringa yukta sahakarani eva upameyani. Tam asatyam krutva. Asatyam krutva means here he does not directly say na ete bringaha athava na etani bringa yuktani sahakara pushpani kintu kalakutam eva iti. He has not directly expressed that, but instead he says bringa chalena kalakutam uttankitam prativishikam anena madanena. So upameya vastu is sabringam, sahakara pushpam. Tam asatyam krutva upamanam kalakutam shara kalaku sa kalakutaha sharaha kalakuta yuktaha sharaha eva atra upamanam tachcha atra satyataya sthapitam anena prativishikam kalakutam uttankitam eva iti. It has been he establishes it and or affirms it in a in the shloka, and without directly negating bringa bhramaram, he just by artham we understand that. Okay, and the kapatartha shabdam is chala here, and without the nanya he uses the chala to indicate nishedham. It is only a nishedhasya pratiti. Okay, the same way another manner in which apannuti can also be expressed is by using the word parinamati. So in this shlokam, Amushmin Lavanyamrita Sarasi Nunam Mrigadrishaha Swaraha Sharva Plushtaha Prithu Jagana Bhage Nipatitaha Yad Anga Angaranam Prathama Pishuna Nabhi Kuhare Shikha Dhumasyayam Paranamati Romavali Vapuhu Atra Nora Na Romavalihi Dhumashikayam Iti Pratipattihi. The text, he gives a context which I don't know if it will work, but let's see. So here, Veshya Dasi Kvachit Samriddha Lampatam Kaminam Prati Veshyam Varnayati. So Veshya Dasi, a courtesan's servant, is describing the courtesan to a Samriddha Kamukaha, a wealthy person who is approaching that courtesan, that lady, this Veshyastri. So she is actually describing her merits in this shloka, and he says, Rasika, so Amushmin Lavanya Amrita Sarasi Noonam Mrigadrishaha Mrigadrishaha Lavanya Sarasi. So Sharva Plushtaha Smaraha, idea is Manmatha was burnt by Shiva. And that Manmatha, when he was burnt, he fell down and he actually fell in her waist. Prithu Jagana Bhage Saha Nipatitaha. Asyaha Mrigadrishaha Asyaha Amushmin Lavanya Amrita Sarasi. Her Shariram is like a Lavanya Amrita Saras. Her body is like a lake of beauty. Tasmin Prithu Jagana Bhage. Prithu Jagana Bhage, her waist, which is Prithu, which is very wide, and in that Smaraha Nipatitaha. Manmatha has come and fallen down. When did he fall? How was he? Sharva Plushtaha. Shivena Dagdaha Smaraha. Mrigadrishaha Asyaha Naikayaha. Amushmin Lavanya Amrita Sarasi. Prithu Jagana Bhage. Noonam Nipatitaha. I am sure he has come and fallen down. So when a coal which is burnt comes, when you drop it into a body of water, smoke arises immediately, right? When anything hot comes and falls in contact with cold water, smoke comes up, a trail of smoke comes up. Now here he says that the Romavali that is there on her stomach is actually not a line of hair, but it is Dhumashikha. Because Manmatha, after being burnt by Shiva, has come and fallen into her Nabhi Kuharam. And from there, the Dhumam that comes out of her Nabhi, it is actually Dhumam. The Romavalihi, Romavali Vapuhu, Dhumasya Shikha Parinamati. So her Romavali is actually not, it transforms into a Dhumashikha. It is not a Romavali. So that transformation is the is what gives us the idea of Apannuti here. So yat smaraha sharva plushtaha smaraha shivena dagda manmatha, being burnt by Shiva, noonam has definitely nipatitaha fallen, prithu jagana bhage in her waist, that is a lake of beauty, amishmin mrigadrishaha amushmin lavanya amrita sarasi, in this lake of beauty of her form. Yat, because his body, anga angara angaranam prathama pishuna tasya anga yat yasya manmatasya angani eva angaram coal. So his body has now become reduced to hot coal. Anga angaranam nabhi kuhare yat anga angaranam Prathama Pishuna, yeah, as the first indication of his body, which is like coal, the smoke trail comes from her navel. So Dhumasya Shika Iyam Romavali Vapuhu Dhumasya Shika Parinamati. The form of Romavali, it is actually the Dhumashika that comes out in the form of this Romavali. So atra na romavalihi kintu dhumashikayeva romavali rupena parinamati iti parinama arthaka shabdena nishedasya pratitihi. Purirda? சோ அத்ர
எத்து எந்து எத் எத் அங் அங்கங்
எது
அங்காங்கார
அங்க அங்காராணாம் அங்கிறச்சு எஸ்ய மன்மதஸ்ய அங்கா அந்த மன்மதனுடைய அங்கங்கள் தான் அங்காரம் அங்காரா இஸ் கோல் ஆர் எதுங்கிறச்ச எஸ்மாத் காரணாத் சி எஸ்ய ஸ்மரஸ்ய அங்காணி ஏவ அங்காராக ஆர் யூ கேன் ஆல்சோ சே எது எஸ்மாத் காரணாத் அங்க அங்காராணாம் சோ பிரசமஸ்ய நிர்வாணதாயாக சாந்தேகே பிசுனா தட் இஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் அங்க அங்காராணாம் கர்ச்சு அகேன் ஸ்மரஸ்ய அங்க அங்காணி ஏவ அங்காராக So the moment Shiva burnt it, it was reduced to coal and it was hot. It came and fell down in her Amrita Saras. Lavanyameva Amrita Saras. Actually, vandu, Rupakam and Apannuti, Rupakam aids Apannuti. Angangi bhavam inge. You take it as an example for Arthi.
Apannuti.
ஆர்த்தி அபர்ணுதி ஆல்சோ வியாஜோக்தியும் சொல்லலாம் இந்த இடத்துல வியாஜோக்தி அக்கார்டிங் டு கோலியானந்த் ஐ திங்க்
அவர் யா வேற ஏதாவது வச்சிருப்பாரு அந்த மாதிரி பண்ணி நம்ம தீன்ற மாதிரி எல்லாம் சொல்றதுக்கு
பங்கந்தரேன நெக்ஸ்ட் சோ டு கன்க்ளூட் திஸ் அபர்ணுதி ஹி சேஸ் ஏவம் இயம் பங்கந்தரைஹி அபி ஊஹ்யா ஹி கிவ்ஸ் தி எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் அங்கங்கே விசங்கிரே இந்த வியாக்கியானம் So, Kaitava Apannuti, if you look, he gives many different yukti for understanding that Apannuti, not only na, etc. இதுல தான் பார்க்கணும் கைதவா அப்பநுத்தில தான் பார்க்கணும் ஹாலுவா ஹலோ நைவ விஷம் விஷம் பிரமா ஐயோ திருப்பி அதை பிடிக்கணும் போல இருக்கு சேகாபன்னுதி இல்ல இதுவும் இல்ல நாட் திஸ்
இது அங்கம் கேபியா
இல்ல கைதவா பன்னுதி பங்கியந்தரைஹி அப்படிங்கிறது இருக்கோ இல்லையோ கைதவா சி அங்கம் கேபி சசங்கரே ஹி ஆக்சுவலி கிவ்ஸ் இட் அஸ் அன் எக்ஸாம்பிள்
ஆமா சுத்தத்துக்கு
பட் இங்க வந்து பங்கியந்தரேன தட்ஸ் ஆல் இல்லையா நமக்கு வந்து ஒரு பங்கியந்தரேன மீன்ஸ் கைதவ கைதவ நின்னவ சல தேர் ஆர் மெனி டிஃபரெண்ட் வேர்ட்ஸ் தட் யூ கேன் யூஸ் டு டினை தி உபமேயம் ஆர் த வர்ணனீய வஸ்து இதம் தே கேன உக்தம் இத்தியபி பிரதிபாதனம் ஓகே தெர் இஸ் அனதர் ஸ்லோகா தட் வி ரெட் இன் சப்தம உல்லாசம் இதம் தே கேன உக்தம் இதி ஐ டிட் லுக் அட் தட் ஸ்லோகம் ஐ ஷுட் ஹவ் ப்ராபபிலி நான் இது இருக்கேன்னு விட்டுட்டேன் சி கோபனீயம் கமபி அர்த்தம் தியோதயித்வா கதஞ்சன யதி ஸ்லேஷேன அன்யதாவா அன்யதயா அன்யதயேது சா அபி அபன்னுதிஹி இஃப் யூ யூ ஆர் ட்ரைங் டு கவர் சம்திங் கோபனீயம் வஸ்து கமபி அர்த்தம் தியோதயித்வா யூ ஆர் ட்ரைங் டு ஹைலைட் தட் வஸ்து விச் இஸ் விச் யூ வாண்ட் டு கவர் சோ நாயம் சுதாம்சு கிம் தர்ஹி வியோமகங்கா சரோருகம் திஸ் இஸ் நாட் த மூன் ஆர் இட் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி லோட்டஸ் தட் இஸ் தேர் இன் த ஆகாஷகங்கா சோ தட் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்லோகம் தட் வீல் சே தட் இன்ஃபேக்ட் இஃப் யூ டோன்ட் யூஸ் நாயம் அண்ட் இன்ஸ்டெட் இஃப் யூ யூஸ் ஸ்லேஷ to give to negate the you know nishedaha krutva nishedam krutva anyat satyataya sthapane shleshaha yati upayujyate tatrapi apannutihi so there can be many different types of apannuti here so he just divides it in a very broad aspect and says shabda apannuti shabdi apannutihi and arthi apannutihi there are only two types of apannuti and in shabdi apannutihi it is you use nanya or na na ayam iti varnaniyasya nishedah sakshat shabdena kriyate tat shabdhi tatra shabdi apannutih if you use any other methodology without saying na then everything else comes under arthi apannutih it is easier I feel this division of mamata. So we'll stop with this.